it's been quite a few days since I did a vlog at sunset. The sun has just now gone down behind the house in back of my brother and my nephew's house. But I've been wanting to, I have to admit, it's kind of selfish. I want to do it for me. I've got my vaccination, first and second shots. As it happened, I got Pfizer. And the Center for Disease Control has come out with the news that we don't have to wear masks outdoors anymore. But of course, when we go to the store, we have to. Indoors, with people we don't know, we have to. And when I finally get around to taking my car over to the mechanic to have some work done on it, I'll have to wear a mask there too. But in spite of the terrible news from India and Brazil and other places where they're suffering, they've got it bad. But in spite of that bad news, it appears that here in the United States, at least, I hope things are better where you are, my vlogging friends around the world. But it appears, oh my, there are ants foraging. I hope they don't decide to eat my feet. It appears things are a little better now in the United States. Of course, everything could still go to hell in a handbasket, as the saying is. But I'm starting to feel a little more hopeful about my own personal future. I haven't gotten the plague yet, and they tell me I'm safer now that I'm vaccinated. Even if I do get it, it probably won't kill me. That's what they say. Now, I've been living here at my brother and my nephew's house since last August, around about the 20th, 21st, 22nd of August it was, when they brought me here from the hospital after I had my heat stroke up in the mountains where I'd been camping for 2 weeks. I've been here September, October, November, December, January, February, March, and today is the last day of April. I've been here 8 months, and I think, knock on wood, I think I'll be going soon. I do have some good news also, in addition to the widespread good news that it looks like things might be improving, and I hope they do get better in India and Brazil. I pray they recover. But here in California, things are a little better, and in many of the states of the Union, the United States, the southern states, the northern states, the eastern states, the western states, it looks like things might be getting a little better. And I think it's almost time for me to... Oh, I was going to tell you the good news is. Some of you know I have a son. And some of you saw some of my videos from when I went to his wedding. A year and 4 months ago. In Brooklyn, before the plague began. And back in October 31st and November 1st, the year 2018. No, I'm sorry. It was 2019. Last year was 2018. They celebrated their first anniversary. Well, my daughter-in-law. Did you hear the neighbors out there squealing their tires? Yeah. My daughter-in-law found out a little over a month ago, almost 2 months ago. She found out, boy, there they go over there, they're going that way. Friday night, you know, the last day of April. My daughter-in-law found out. And my son called me to tell me. Almost a month ago now, he called me to tell me. It's supposed to be a secret for a while. Tell me that she is pregnant. Actually, that's not what he said. What he said to me was, "Hey, Dad, how do you feel about being a grandfather?" Oh, yeah. I told you it's good news. New life is good news. So I said, well, I feel pretty good about it, actually. And so they said to me, yeah. Last week they told me it looks like it's going to be a boy. Right away I said they should name him after my daughter-in-law's father. May he rest in peace. He was not at the wedding because he's been gone for a few years. I'm sorry to say, because I think I would have liked the guy. The things people said about him at the wedding and before the wedding at the party the night before. I paid for that party. It was fun. The dog's growling. They want to go back inside. Maybe I'll let him in. Anyhow, so many people said such wonderful things about her father and how they were sorry, how they were sad that he wasn't there with them right then. So I said, well, you know, if it's a boy, you might name him after his other grandfather. I think they like that. So maybe that'll be his name. They briefly touched on naming after me, and I said, hell, I don't, no way. He's already got my last name, probably. If that's what you decide on, it's up to you, but they had already told me they were going to call him. His last name would be my son's last name, my last name. So, if that's true, he's already named after me and after his fallen father. But I think it would be good to have a new use of the name of a man who, I'm sorry, I didn't know him. But anyway, I've been chewing on that good news for almost 2 months now. And pretty much was thinking already about going back there. And then my son told me that they expect me to come back there. So I may yet have a chance to have my dream of driving across the country from California to New York. And that's not the only news that's come down personally in my world and in my family within the last few weeks that I've been not making any vlog every night after sunset. I started off this month, I was going to vlog every night after sunset, under sunset, V-E-N-U-S, Venus, vlog every night under sunset. Well, it's under sunset now. You see the light on the back over there, on the wall, right up there. That's the last bit of light. I can't see the sun now. And there's some clouds out there too. We might have some colors here. If the camera decides it can keep on running for a few minutes, I might be able to show you some sunset colors. Oh, look, this is my pandemic beard. You know, lots of things have happened in the pandemic. I never cut my hair to start with. It's been growing out, and I did cut my beard a few months ago, but it's been 3 or 4 months that it's grown back in. My pandemic beard. Yeah. If I can get this band around my hair. There we go. You can see my little tail there. My little ponytail. My little pony tail. So, let's see, there was something else that was new. Oh, yeah. For a couple of months now, I've been talking with my brother about this, that, and the other. And I reminded him that if push comes to shove, we do own the house back down in the suburbs of San Diego, a little suburban town called La Mesa. We own the house there that we grew up in. My mom kept that house. And when she died, in her will, she left it to my brother and myself. And we've been getting the rent on it. $800 or $900 a month apiece. About $1,800 rent after expenses. California's really expensive. I mean, and our rent there at that house, we charge them $2,200 a month. And that's a deal for San Diego, for a good neighborhood like it sits in. Nice house. It's not a big house, but it's your typical American dream house from the 50s and the 60s. It was built in 1958. And we lived in it starting January 1959. And we grew up there, went to school, and my mom hung on to it, and she collected the rent after she married my stepfather, moved in with him. That was his house where I used to blog at from 2007 until 2008, 20. Last August 2020 was the last time I vlogged there. That was my stepfather's house, and it goes to my stepsister and her brothers, and they've been working on it. And they're gonna try to sell that too. They'll probably get more than my brother and I will, because their house has a view, beautiful view. You may remember, I've showed you sometimes, back in the day, going out in the backyard, looking down into Mission Valley, and looking at the stadium. They tore the stadium down since I moved out. Yeah, they're building a smaller stadium for San Diego State University. But the big stadium is gone now. It's been torn down. Anyhow, my brother and I decided we were gonna sell our little dream house, our American dream house. It only has 3 bedrooms and 2 bathrooms. But it's really beautiful and a nice house. It's quiet on the side of a hill. It doesn't have a view. Unless, of course, you look up. You could look up and see the hill above you. But it doesn't have a view of the city like some of those houses up on the hill do. Up above my brother and my house, there's a view. There are houses that have a view of the city of San Diego. But ours doesn't, no. But we've pretty much decided we're going to sell it. And so I'll have a little bit of money, a little bit more than I expected. I'll be able to perhaps buy myself a mobile home out in the desert. But that's been pushed back now because I want to go to New York and be there when the baby is born. That's right. There's a dog. Look at it. There's a dog. I see her. There she is. There she is, yes. There's a doggy. So, yeah. What's up, girl? What's up? So I want to go back east and be there when my grandbaby and my grandchild is born. Probably going to be a grandson, they say. So, that's the other piece of news. The first piece of news was that my daughter-in-law is pregnant. And I'm now free to tell people. For a while, I wasn't supposed to tell anyone. Just me and my brother, and that's all. Now we can tell everybody personally. So I'm telling you, my friends, that good news has happened, and I'm going to be a grandfather, God willing, and the creek don't rise. And the other news is my brother and I are going to sell the house we were kids in. When we moved in, he was 3 months old when we moved in, and I was 8 years old when we moved in. And we pretty much lived there. I went away now and then. I went away to school and live with my friends when I was in my late teens and early 20s. But when I was 27, no, when I was 26, my father died. Our father, my brother and my father. He was 18 and I was 26. and he died. Our father died. And my mother was kind of a wreck. And then she met an old friend of hers that she knew many, many years before, back in the 30s and the 40s in San Diego. And he'd been married too, but his wife had died 2 or 3 years before that. And he asked her to marry him. And in 1978, my mother and my stepfather got married. And from then, for the next 30 years, 78 to 88 to 98, to the summer of 2007 when my stepfather died, they lived together in that house that I've logged at for a few years. After he died, my mom asked me to come live with her, help her keep the house so she didn't have to leave it. And she stayed in that house for the next 11 years. And she died in that house. She stayed in that house. She got to stay at home until the day she died. That's something else I have to keep in mind, is my day is coming too, you know. Maybe I'll live 10 years, maybe I'll live 1 year, I don't know. But the longer I live, probably the more incapacitated and incompetent I will become. And I'll have to fix it so I'm in a place where I can first take care of myself, and then if there's any emergencies, I'll be able to get to medical care. And that's another worry altogether. And it's not the news I have to tell you. The news I have to tell you is those two things about me becoming a grandfather and my brother and I selling the house that we lived in when we were children. Yeah. There's a little bit of color, not much, but a little bit. Yes. So, that's kind of what I wanted to tell you, what's been happening with me. I've been through some grief in the years gone by, and some happiness. I remember when my son was born, that was a wonderful, wonderful, wonderful night. I felt so wonderful to know that he was born safe, and his mother was safe, and everybody was safe. That was a wonderful time. And I hope in October, when their baby is born, I hope it will be born safe, healthy. My daughter-in-law will be fine and get through it okay. And I hope I'm there in New York when it happens. But that means I'll have to straighten up some of the storage units. I still have stuff stored in here, down in San Diego, south of here. Get rid of a lot of stuff and select the best and the most precious things that I want to save. And then go back east for a while. Well, I don't have much more to tell you, except that my vlogging friends, I'm still making crazy little movies. If you want to, you can see them here over at the other site or at YouTube or at Vimeo. And now and then I make a regular video log, a vlog, a vlog like this one, or just turn on the camera and talk. And that's about it. So, God bless you and keep you. Take care of yourselves. And remember, vlog on.